with a fork hand. And he was lactose intolerant.
Oh my god, that's terrifying.
He loved cats.
Oh my god, how much did he love them?
He had 100.
Oh, BT Dubs, the cats are in our snacks.
Son of a bitch. Back to Bobby Joe. One day his mom was making him pancakes. And his dad came in. And he threw a snowball in his face.
Why is it snowing? What time of year is it?
He was lived in Colorado. Then.
What part of Colorado?
Colorado, main campus, State Avenue.
He was at the university? He was in college? What did you tell me? He was a seamstress. His story has a lot of holes. A lot of holes.
He was so
weird. I'm not scared.
But he worked at the college.
As a seamstress for the varsity basketball team.
So, anyways.
Sewing jerseys.
One night when Bobby head off from work and he didn't have any classes.
Oh, that's frightening.
He had a campfire with his best friend, Sean.
Sean who?
Sean Raymond.
Is he related to Usher Raymond?
Yes, but get off my back. So Bobby, he and Sean went into the spooky, spooky town woods of Colorado.
What's the town name?
Barbecue
Colorado? I've never heard of Barbecue Colorado.
That's because you're dumb.
Maybe.
So here he was on the spookiest, darkest, mooniest night in all of the land.
How moony was it?
The mooniest. And anyways, it was so scary. He was so scared.
Why was he so scared?
Because he had an ulcer. And he knew. He knew that if he got too scared, his ulcer would bust. So him and Sean went on a camping trip. And then Sean thought it'd be fun to go out in the woods and see if they could find any ghosts.
Oh.
And long story short, there were no ghosts.
They didn't find any?
And his ulcer never busted.
This is a stupid story.
And Bobby
his ulcer didn't even burst.
And Bobby and Sean went home and had lasagna. But this is where it gets really spooky. You know why?
Why do you have? When
does Bobby is lactose intolerant? That's the end of my story. What do you got, kid?